she's been gone a while.
She'll come back.
If they catch her, they'll kill her.
They won't catch her.
She's costing us time. It's just that we need to get to Marine. Every day we lose here is a day that Talia or Ryan could be hurt or worse. You must return home safely, Asher, and, well, you have a history of putting your faith in women who may not deserve it.
She's my friend, Uncle. She's been at my side for a long time. Was it them? The Lost Legion?
Aye. Too many for us to take. I counted about 24, maybe more, as well as horses. About half a mile down the canyon, and coming fast. Had to run my arse off to avoid getting caught. It's nearly empty. You two care if I finish it off?
It might be a while before we find more water.
Nah. Drink up.
Thanks.
Right. We need to get moving.
The Lost Legion. We're 100 miles from Yunkai. When are they going to give up?
Never. They're still raw about T'Zaal.
Yes, well, perhaps you shouldn't have snapped his neck. There is such a thing as overdoing it.
Let me remind you, it was him who tried to kill us. I just returned the favor.
Oh, don't doubt it. He always did have a gift for that sort of thing.
It's only a matter of time before they overtake us. Ah! Bugger a harpy!
Can we double back?
Not without meeting our mates from Yunkai. We're well and truly fucked this time, Asher.
During severe winters, when the Skahazadan floods, it carves out great underground rivers in the sandstone.
And
when those waters recede, those rivers become caves. And those caves might hide us, if we can find them. I mean, we're trapped for the moment, but...
Thank you, Malcolm. That's valuable advice.
Of course.
If he's right about this, I may actually stab him.
Looks like we're not alone. No obvious wounds. Maybe he died of thirst. Listen. That's water. I hear water.
From underground. There might be a cave nearby.
I think I see a light in there.
A way through.
Oh, we couldn't be that lucky. Oh, shit. It's them.
Ponte Freedom! Che si rizzi!
Shit! Come on!
Go, go! Behind us!
This was a bad idea.
Damn it!
Asha! Find us another way out of here!
Got it! What in seven hells is that smell? I can't even guess what this used to be.
Come.
walk?
I'm fine. There are four wars way worse than this.
Hurry! The beast is coming around!
Listen up, you sorry lot. Gather round. We're handing out assignments today.
Garrett, we'll be men of the watch before nightfall. Right. Sorry. No hard feelings over that business with Finn, yeah? I appreciate you not ratting me out over the knife. It's nice to know there's at least one brother I can trust. Finn might have killed me otherwise.
Just promise me you'll stop stealing things, Cotter.
All right. I swear it. Never again. Well, no guarantees on potatoes or lamprey pie. Or for that matter. Just messing with you, Garrett. I promise. I'll mend my thieving ways.
Well, aren't you two sons of whores looking thick as thieves? Having a good laugh over nicking my knife, eh, Garrett? Men like you turn traitor for nothing. It's in your blood.
I didn't take anything from you.
No, but you protected the bastard who did.
You'll always be an asshole, Garrett.
You're just a fucking craven.
Look, it's over, all right? Just drop it.
You can bugger off if you like.
Finn, leave him alone. It wasn't Garrett's fault. If you're gonna hate someone, hate me.
With pleasure.
Now, it doesn't matter what the world once called you. After today, you're all brothers. Could even be that the man standing next to you saves your life one day. Maybe you'll save his.
Let's find out then, shall we? Casper, to the builders. Finn, to the rangers. Lobor, to the stewards. Hugh, to the rangers. Cotter, to the builders.
And finally, Garrett to the rangers. That's it. May all the gods preserve you.
Well, there we are. I'll be patching up the wall, and you'll be defending it.
Should you northern boys want your gods to give a blessing to this union, there's a weirwood tree beyond the wall. Now form up and follow my lead.
Garrett, it's good to hear you'll be a ranger.
Thank you.
I know you wanted this.
I'm ready to say my vows.
I didn't have many friends when I first arrived at Castle Black. Gwen and Pip, they'd have sooner seen me bloodied in the yard than offer a hand. Now, die for either of them. Our brothers are all we have.
Finn.
Shows you what kind of ripe fools are running this place. I can't believe they made you a ranger. You're not fit for the job. You don't have any balls between your legs.
Like it or not, we're brothers now. means we're gonna have to get along.
Don't count on it.
You wouldn't even be here if you didn't have Snow leading you by the hand the whole way.
I'd keep an eye out for you if you weren't such an ass about everything.
You don't give a shit about me. No one around here gives a shit about me. They wouldn't even care if I...
You know how many rangers are never heard from again in these parts? And I'm about to become one myself. All alone out here. Wildlings everywhere. Or wolves.
It's all right to be afraid. Keeps you alert, keeps you from being too confident. Like the next time we fight. I'll remember that fist of yours rattling my skull and I'll think twice.
I suppose you're right.
You want a different assignment? Because I hear they need someone to clean the shit house.
See, that's why I got so fucking mad at you, Garrett. You're the closest thing I have to a friend.
You handled that well, Garrett. They say the old gods watch us through the weirwoods. More than watch us. They know us. The gods are not forgiving. We brothers have to be. We're here. After this, there's no going back. Now go. Take your vows.
In the eyes of the old gods, the Night's Watch offers you a place beside us. Now say the words for all to hear and embrace us as your own.
Hear my words, and bear witness to my vow. Night gathers, and now my watch begins. It shall not end until my death.
I shall take no wife.
I shall take no wife. Hold no lands. Father no children.
I shall wear no crowns, and win no glory.
I shall wear no crowns. And win no glory. I shall live and die at my post. I am the sword in the darkness. I am the watcher on the wall. I am the shield that guards the realms of men. I pledge my life and honor to the Night's Watch for this night. And all the nights to come.
You knelt as boys. Rise now as men of the Night's Watch.
Welcome to your new family, Garrett.
Men of the watch now. It means we get to piss off the wall whenever we want.
You know you needed an excuse to play with yourself, Finn.
Garrett, you've got a visitor. Over there.
Well, who is it?
Do I look like your fucking squire?
Don't forget the practice shorts.
Uncle Duncan!
Garrett!
It's good to see you. They told me you were at the Weirwood Tree. Wasn't sure you'd be back in time.
I've missed you, Uncle. I never expected to see you here.
A business with the Night's Watch. A delivery of Ironwood shields to keep you all out of harm's way. That settles it then?
Aye, the delivery looks in order.
Oh, the gods do grant miracles. You look well, nephew. I'm told you're a ranger now. That's good.
Uncle?
Things aren't going well at Ironwrath, Garrett.
I know. I heard the news about Ethan.
I wasn't there when it happened. Small mercy, I suppose. Not having to see our lord struck down with such barbarity. But House Forrester is nothing if not resilient. Our house has survived for centuries.
I should have been there protecting Ethan. What good am I at the wall?
That's why I'm really here. Do you recall Lord Forrester's last words to you? Just before he died, Gregor's final command, spoken to you in confidence.
He said the North Grove must never be lost.
Indeed. But first, it must be found. I've been reading his journals, scouring the legends for any clue what Lord Forrester knew. I think I've found the answer. He describes a fortification, a protected citadel of sorts, hidden from the world, one filled with great power. It was scattered among his notes. Almost an obsession, a vital secret he protected at all costs.
Do you think this citadel can help us save House Forrester?
Lord Forrester certainly believed so. He speaks of it as if he'd seen it himself. Somewhere north of the wall. And you must find it, Garrett. The search won't be easy. But you're a Tuttle. Our lord knew you wouldn't fail him.
Somewhere north of the wall. That's not a lot to go on, Uncle. How am I supposed to find it?
The first chance you get to head north, take it.
And then?
You leave the Night's Watch behind and strike out on your own. This is no small request I make. I know that. But there's no other choice.
Uncle, that's desertion. The Night's Watch execute men who desert.
I know. I wouldn't ask this of you if there was another way. This will help guide you. I found it hidden in Lord Forrester's strongbox.
What is that?
A page from our lord's journal. But one he tore out and kept separate. Why? I don't know.
It's a map. To the North Grove.
Aye.
I used to be frightened of Weirwood Trees. Well, before I was a man grown. I swear. I actually could hear him whispering sometimes. Bloody ice dragon. Gods be good. Now that I would love to see.
This looks familiar.
What is it, Garrett?
Talia gave me this. Before I left.
Oh. Wait. Lord Forrester gave Ethan a similar one as well. Roderick too.
Look, there's a clasp.
It must open.
I had no idea this was inside. Another Weirwood.
But why?
Maybe it's a key to solving the map. Perfect fit. Maybe it's telling us where to look on the map.
the whole map that has to turn. Mouth, Uncle. Whatever this place is, the North Grove must be near.
There's only one way to find out. Here, take this map. Everything we hold dear may well depend on your success. It's a lot to put on your shoulders. The lives of a whole house.
But I'll try, Uncle. It's no small task. I'm still just a squire.
I know what I'm asking of you. But I know you're up to the challenge. God's watch over you. You're the son I never had.
Let's go, Garrett. I don't know. Probably like little shards or something.
I hope to never lift one of those again.
Wait, so, like a weapon?
Well, your piss is like any other liquid, I reckon.
Yeah, mine's mostly ale.
And if it froze on the way down the wall?
Well, that was rather mysterious. A stranger arrives and you're chatting him up.
Someone said it was your uncle looking for you. Well, what did he want?
Looked like you two had a lot to talk about.
Must have been important to come to Castle Black.
He's castellan to House Forrester. They sell ironwood to the builders.
So you were just talking about lumber all that time?
It looked like he gave you something.
It was nothing. Let's go and celebrate.
Already keeping secrets from your brothers, eh?
Garrett's right. The wall's gonna melt before we get up there. Come on.
There are so many guests already arriving. And have you seen the wedding decorations they put up in the gardens? So beautiful. You know, we're as lucky as she is. Marjorie was but a lady when we were sent to serve at Highgarden. But in just a few days' time, we'll be attending to a queen at a royal feast. Where we're standing, we'll be able to see everyone. And everyone will be able to see us. We've certainly come a long way, haven't we? I've been meaning to say what I told you about my family. It means a lot to be able to share that with someone. Someone I can trust.
If handmaidens don't help each other in King's Landing, nobody will.
Thank you, Mira. And you know I'll always help you too. Hold on, look. There he is.
Lord Morgrin?
No, no, next to him. Lord Tarwick. I don't want to be a handmaiden forever. And this wedding may be the best chance of meeting a husband I'll ever have. I have to go talk to him. Marjorie won't notice it for a few minutes longer. Could you make an excuse for me? Please.
Go on then. It'll be fine. The wedding's still days away.
Thank you, Mira. I knew I could count on you.
What are you doing here?
I know I shouldn't be here. We have to talk. I didn't know when I would see you next.
Look, that night, I don't know what might have happened if you hadn't helped me.
I could say the same to you, Lady Mira. But I came here to warn you. I was down in Fleabottom last night when I overheard a couple of Lannister guards talking about...
Shh!
They already know he's missing, probably dead. They're questioning people, searching for his body. It's not safe.
They don't have any proof he's dead, do they?
They found blood. blood on the garden stones by the fountain. But they can't know it's his. No one will know what you did. What? What is it? If we're gonna survive this, there can't be any details we've overlooked.
I still have his knife.
Oh, no. Just keep it hidden and clean the blood off it. Meantime, just stay out of sight.
How? Do you forget who I serve?
Just don't get in any more trouble. And I'll watch your back. We're in this together now.
Why are you helping me?
What do you mean? I'm a friend, Lady Mira. My name's Tom. We help each other, or it's both our heads.
What were you even doing there that night?
I once told you, there are people who'd be willing to help you. People who want you alive. I'm here to make sure that happens.
Wait, what? You mean someone... Mira?
My lady.
Really? A tryst in the bushes with that coal boy? Not to say it's wrong, but with all the lords and knights in King's Landing... Oh, thank the gods you came along, Sarah. That boy. He fancies me. He'll find any excuse to talk. I just don't have the heart to drive him off. So you misled him? I wouldn't waste the time. Come on. Marjorie expects us at the throne room. We don't want to be late. You can tell me all about this Lord Tarwick on the way. Well, first of all, his name's Garibald, and he has this really funny accent. He told me the cleverest story about this festival they have where they celebrate.
And I've given the musicians a list of songs to play for Joffrey at the feast. I assume you have no problems with the reigns of Castamere?
I trust you've chosen all the standards. But just to be sure, I'll draw up a list of wedding ballads we favor in Highgarden.
Your Grace, my lady.
Which reminds me, Joffrey will require his Kingsguard close at hand during the feast. I'm afraid we'll have no room for your handmaidens.
But we...
What was that? Do you object? Is that what I heard? If you're going
Your
to
Grace,
speak out of turn, girl,
I...
You should finish what you start.
We do as you command, Your Grace. And we'll spend the feast wherever it pleases you.
You'll spend it mopping the stables, if I please. I asked your handmaiden here at the Iron Throne whom she would serve if forced to choose between yourself and the king. She was deferential to the crown then, as she is now. But words are wind. In any case, it's settled. The king's guard will stay with Joffrey. Your handmaidens will sit elsewhere.
Of course, Your Grace. Anything for my beloved Joffrey.
Lady Marjorie, we may not see eye to eye on everything, but I hope you will at least agree with me that our handmaidens should know their place. And that place is not with my brother, Tyrion.
What did she mean by that? You and Tyrion? What you do reflects on me. If something's going on, I need to know about it.
We only shed some wine, my lady.
Drinking wine with Tyrion Lannister. Sarah, what do you know of this?
Tyrion approached us, my lady. It was his idea, not Mira's.
I don't care what your intentions were, Mira. You went to a Lannister behind my back. I've only ever tried to help you. Why are you making trouble for me?
Please, Lady Marjorie, trust me. I know what I'm doing. I've learned from the best.
I don't have the time or patience for your games, Mira. Right now, I need you both to be my handmaidens, and that's all I need you to be. Let there be no mistake. If I hear of you speaking so much as a word to Tyrion Lannister again, you can go home to your family.
I promise I won't speak to him again. Please, don't send me home.
This can't happen again.
Roderick, it's the White Hills. They're assembling in the courtyard. They've woken the house. You can't let this go on. They want to see us cower.
I'll need my sentinel. Go ahead, Talia, and have Roiland meet me in the courtyard.
What is this?
It's a parade of dead men if I have my way.
What is the meaning of this? I demand to know.
Those are strong words. For a cripple who can't carry a sword.
All of you, show your respect to Griff Whitehill, fourth-born son of Lord Lud Whitehill and commander of this garrison.
Cocky Roderick, we used to call you. Swinging your prick round, lording it over my family. Now look at you, eh? Roderick the Ruined. I hardly recognize you. But the name fits, don't it? How pathetic.
Get your men out of my sight. This is absurd.
That sounds like the old Roderick, beating his chest every chance he got. I don't think he gets it.
No, my lord. I don't think he does.
Your brother Ethan didn't get it either.
You bite your tongue.
I am in charge now. And the first thing you need to know is that if I am not happy, no one is happy. So my men are taking over your great hall. That's where we'll quarter from now on.
What? You can't.
You'll have to go through me.
I won't have my men sleeping out in your barn in shit and filth. Maybe that's how foresters live, but not us.
I don't care if you're happy or not. You'll quarter where I tell you.
I wasn't fucking asking, Roderick. And what's more, you will treat my men right. I've heard what you've done, and if they're eating wormy bread, then your people better be eating shit off the ground. I'm not here to keep them in line. I'm here to keep you in line. You think you're being clever?
If your men don't like it here, you can march them back to High Point.
Watch yourself, Roderick.
This is against the King's law. You've no right to make such demands.
I have every right. We're here under the orders of Roose Bolton, Warden of the North. So I will be in your halls. I will be in your courtyard. I will sit on your fucking council and be in your bedchambers if I bloody well please.
You can't do this, little bastard. You can't just do whatever...
We'll do what we were sent here to do.
You're mad, Griff. This is my house and you will do as I say.
Why should I listen to some cripple with half a face? Now! Me and my men will take our place in your hall. Unless you think you and your army can stop me. No, you know better than that. You know where we'll be.
This is outrageous.
Roderick!
You can't go in there.
We can and we will. Unless you want this all to end right now. Eh? I'm the only lord here.
Come on. Griff Whitehill, that snot-nosed fourthborn, parading in here like a conquering fucking hero.
It was bad enough when it was just the soldiers.
We can't live with them under our roof, soiling our house.
I know you tried to stop them, Malord. But we can only take this occupation for so long. Our people will break. And the way Griff Whitehill came in, that's clearly what he wants. Nothing worse than a fourthborn with something to prove. But Griff Whitehill isn't the beginning of our troubles, or the end of them. We need to look at all the pieces. Whitehill men aren't just in our house. They've raided our lands, burnt farms, and cut down our trees. All the way from here to High Point.
How do we kill a snake, then? By smashing its head.
Griff isn't the head. It's his father.
Perhaps. But Griff is here. We have access to him.
And they have Ryan. He carved these soldiers himself. I don't care what Gwyn Whitehill may have told you at the funeral. Who knows what horrors they're putting him through, held prisoner at High Point. You can't forsake his safety.
But we have to do something.
My lord, at least give us a target to aim for.
Get Ryan out and bring him home. Once he's safe, he can face the Whitehills head on.
And what of Griff and his men? But we can only take this occupation for so long.
If you think I'm giving up on Ironwrath, you're wrong. By keeping this family together, Ironwrath will stand.
Roderick is right. We are nothing if we leave Ryan behind.
Then it's decided. We're bringing Ryan back.
We still don't have the men to hold our own home, let alone storm High Point. We lost most of our men with Gregor at the Twins.
Thankfully, Roderick secured an alliance with the Glenmores.
But those forces mean nothing until after the marriage.
That means we have to count on Asha and Myrra.
How?
Asha means to sail home from Essos with a company of hardened sellswords. But they're not bannermen. We'll need to pay them for it. Which is why Mira's part to play is just as crucial. She can get us the coin we need in King's Landing.
You don't imagine we have the luxury of waiting for them. Asha and Myrra are a long way from here.
I have faith in my children.
I don't think Lud Whitehall will kindly stand by while we pull ourselves together.
Our very lives and the future of House Forrester are at stake. We have to let them try. It's the only way.
Then we hold fast. The Whitehills aren't ready for war.
It won't be long before you're able to take action yourself.
Well, one way or another, there's a fight brewing, so I have much to prepare, and men to train.
My lord?
My lord, there may be something we can do now. A voice from High Point, Gwyn Whitehill.
I spoke with her at the funeral.
As did I, and she's willing to meet. Away from her father's guards. I may not be your sentinel, but please consider this. It would be wise to hear what she has to say.
Do you think she can be trusted?
It's possible she has other motives, but it's a chance to learn more about our enemies. We need to take it, and I'll make sure no one else knows. For now, at least.
Good.
Handle things right with Gwyn, and she may even help us in High Point, when the time comes.
I want the dove pie served with a spoon of lemon cream. We'll have to let the kitchens know. And these flowers, they're just all wrong in the Crownlands. Mira, are you listening to me?
Lady Marjorie, good tidings to you today.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion.
And you, Lady Mira, a word in private, if I may. I'll return her shortly.
Who would I be to deny Lord Tyrion?
Very soon you'll be the queen. And if you're anything like the current one, you'll deny me all you like.
I'm sorry, Lord Tyrion, but Lady Marjorie needs me.
Very well. Just know that matter we discussed? A royal decree sits on my desk now, and I'll have my squire Podrick see to it at the first opportunity. I thought you would want to know. Good news on a day that is already blessed.
Thank you for telling me, Lord Tyrion.
Oh, one more thing. The most valuable favor is a favor unspent. Perhaps I'll call on you for a dance at the wedding feast. Enjoy the festivities.
Goodbye, Lord Tyrion.
Lady Marjorie, welcome to the family. For better or worse.
Lord Tyrion. If you'd only shared some wine with Tyrion, why does he come to you now? What's this talk of a royal decree? You know I didn't want you talking to him. Today of all days.
Lord Tyrion is helping my family, my lady.
So it may seem, but he's exceedingly cunning, Mira. Don't think you know all he's up to. House Forrester already has so few friends at court, and when this decree becomes public, you may find you have even fewer. You disappoint me, Mira. We'll talk about this after the wedding. Sarah will help me with my gown and hair.
But...
come with me, Sarah.
Garrett.
Easy now.
Sorry. I was just keeping at the ready.
That's good. Don't lose that. I understand your uncle paid you a visit. What did he want? Not many people pass through here. What brought him this far?
He was just delivering ironwood shields for the Night's Watch.
Good. Our stocks are running low.
I know it couldn't be easy seeing him. But you have to leave all that behind.
Especially now that you're a ranger.
Aye.
I know you had told me you could stand with these men, but not every brother's a friend, if it came to it. And you were in trouble north of the wall. Any of them you'd trust by your side?
You know these men. Who do you want watching your back?
Finn can handle himself. I'd bring him to a fight.
I'm glad you can trust your brother. I'll remember him.
Herald Holt of White Harbor, Corliss Wells from Stony Sept. And finally, we've got more spawn of nobility joining us.
No.
Brit Warwick of House Whitehill.
It can't be.
Check House Whitehill. Make sure you're not bringing this one for the Boltons. Here.
There'll be a hot meal in the mess hall. After that, we'll be sorting out gear at the armory.
Garrett.
We'll be practice swords to
Garrett,
start.
What's the matter? You know him.
Come on, get moving.
Garrett, who is he?
That man murdered my family.
What?
Snow! See these new recruits to the Maester.
Don't do something you regret.
If it isn't the fucking pig farmer, I'm here because of you. Got sent to the wall for that little party I do with your family. Don't think it's over. Best watch your back.
What are you waiting for, recruit? Personal invitation from the king?
Talk all you like. You'll be dead before you take the black.
Careful now. Didn't end so well for you last time.
That's enough, both of you. I said move.
I'll be seeing you, farm boy.
isn't fair. We were supposed to be up there. I'll never see another wedding like this. I don't know what you did with Tyrion Lannister that made Cersei want to punish you, but it never should have affected me like this.
You just don't get it, Sarah.
I've been fighting for my family's lives here, and what Tyrion Lannister did for me, it may have saved them. Whether you have a seat at the wedding just isn't as important.
I see.
Well, I hope it was worth it, because you don't know how furious Margaery is at you. When I was getting her dressed for the wedding, she was talking about who she could replace you with. I probably shouldn't have even told you, but I suppose you have a right to know. It's funny how things change, isn't it? It must be hard for you not to be the favorite anymore.
Sarah!
Look, it wasn't too long ago I was asking for your help with Margaery, and you were there for me. Maybe now I'm in a position to help you. You just need to ask. Otherwise, Margaery's going to make you leave King's Landing. You're pushing her to it, Mira.
Thank you, Sarah. I could really use a hand right now. I don't want to do this all alone.
Don't worry. We'll figure this out. I'll beg Margaery if I have to. I'm not letting her send you home.
Look! The pie!
Oh no! They're already serving the pie.
Oi!
We're missing everything.
I know you. You were in the gardens the other night with Damien. Before he disappeared. I have a few questions to ask you. What were you doing there with him?
Mira?
Don't think I don't know it was you.
You've made a mistake.
Seven hells.
You there, girl. I need a towel or a wet cloth, something.
Lord Morgren.
You'll need to find someone else. I'm not finished
with
her.
Are you sick, man? You think I have time to bother with handmaidens? Release her or I'll have Queen Cersei find you another job. Well, I just ruined a perfectly good shirt to come to your rescue. No need to explain what that was all about. We all have our own mischief to hide.
Why would you want to help me?
Well, I didn't do it merely for your benefit.
Then why?
Perhaps I recognize a kindred spirit. It's not every little handmaiden who can steal an ironwood decree with the crown right out from under my nose. Consider me impressed. My partners, I am afraid to say, felt rather differently about it.
That ironwood was stolen from my family. It was never yours to sell.
Spoken with strength, my lady. But still, I wonder if you're ready to play this game. Do you even understand why Tyrion gave you the ironwood deal? Because it wasn't out of the kindness of his heart.
I'm no fool. He wants something from me. Access to Margaery. Or perhaps he just knew he could get the cheapest iron.
Very observant. You are no mere handmaiden. I remember what it was like to be new to this game. You feel like you're drowning, don't you? But there's no one you can really trust. What you need more than anything is an ally. I could be that for you, Lady Mira. Is that something you'd be interested in?
And what exactly are the terms of this offer? What do you get out of it?
A smart question. So, let me be blunt. Circumstances have put us at odds. But what if we were to work together? Control the price of ironwood together? We could get very, very rich together. Or should I go back to Blood Whitehill? Who has proven to be very interested in it.
Jeffrey! 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 afraid it just became a very bad time to be linked to Tyrion Lannister. Tell me that you got that Ironwood decree from him before the wedding.
Oh no. He said it was waiting for me on his desk.
What a shame. Such potential. I'm afraid any chance of our alliance has become quite impossible. You understand, Lady Mira.
I can get it. I'll get it back from his chamber.
That would not be an easy task, especially now. But if it were to disappear, perhaps we could talk again. You have a good head for business, Lady Mira. It'd be terribly disappointing to see it on the end of a pike.
Locked. Not getting in this way.
Tom!
What in seven hells do you think you're doing up here? What are you thinking? You've got to leave. Now. You don't know how dangerous this is.
Tom, I'm in trouble. There's something inside I need to get. If I don't, it's going to be a nightmare.
Damn it. Whatever trouble you're in could be trouble for me too.
So what do we do?
I have an idea. The terrace.
The what?
I could maybe climb across the roof and drop down onto the outside terrace. It's just... I don't know, Mira. Is whatever's in there really worth risking my life for? It's not just kings who die stupidly around here.
No. It's not worth your life.
Thank you for saying that. I guess I better not die then. Wait here. I'll be at the door before you know it.
Just what do you think you're doing here? You shouldn't be anywhere near this place. Don't you know the imp has murdered the king?
I work for Lady Marjorie. Queen Marjorie. She asked me to wait here.
Somehow I find that hard to believe. I'm not going to ask you again.
Oi! Whoever's in there, I command you to open this door at once, in the name of the king! You, don't move.
Tom! Me, hurry!
Gods, that was close. I almost didn't make it back down here. Some tiles on the roof came loose. Almost lost my footing.
Tom, we have to hurry. I'm looking for a piece of paper. A royal decree.
Well, go on. That Lannister guard could be back with help any second. I'll keep watch outside the door.
Tom!
You can do this.
Said that it would be on his desk. Tyrion's strongbox. Oh, it must be in here.
Mira, I think the Lannister guard is back.
Oh, no, it's the other one.
Damn it, hide. I'll find a way to distract them.
I'm telling you, I heard someone in here.
Search the place. We'll find them. And after? Now that we've got the imp's keys, we can have a little look inside his lockboxes, eh?
Aye.
Help! Fire!
What the hell? Damn it! Come on!
I lit a tapestry on fire down the hall. I bought you a minute, maybe two.
Oh, thank you.
Did you find it?
Oh, I think it has to be in here. It has to be. No.
Just hurry.
It worked. Is this? Oh, thank the gods. Oh, I found it.
Finally. Let's go.
I catch the bastard who...
I'll wring their bloody neck.
We're not far now. Gwyn Whitehill may already be there.
What is this? Our ironwood trees. It's the Whitehills. You see what they've done? This track was hundreds of years old. And they reduced it to nothing.
Before this is done, we'll make them pay. Every last one of them.
Aye. The Whitehills need to answer for this. And Gwyn needs to answer for this. But we need to find out what she knows. She'll be over there. Be cautious, my lord. If she go around her father to help us, she must have some purpose.
I'll hear what she has to say, but I won't forget who she is.
Good. You see what her family's done here?
Here. You might want this. You may have known each other since you were children, but this could be a trap.
Doesn't hurt to be careful.
Go on. I'll stay with the horses.
It's not enough to take our wood. They must defile our homes.
Damn Whitehills. Cutting down everything they see. Do they understand nothing about ironwood? Well, I remember hiding down there, playing monsters and maidens with little Naaman and Megan.
I see you haven't lost your warrior's ways. That's good. I wouldn't want to deal with someone careless.
Hello, Gwyn.
Roderick. You saw my father's work over there, didn't you? There's no way to miss it.
And he won't stop. He means to do that to every inch of your land.
I have to stop this. It can't go on.
I know. You have to trust me. I don't agree with my father's ways. I wasn't sure you were even going to show. We're taking a risk, meeting like this. Unfortunately, it's the way it has to be.
Thank you for paying respects to my father and brother. And for coming tonight. It's good to see you again.
And you too, Roderick. I think we can help each other. But first, I've heard news of Asher, that he plans to return to Ironwrath. Why is he coming back? I loved him once. I longed for Asher to come back. But not like this.
How do you know about my brother?
That's part of why I'm here. But I need to know you've come for the same reasons I have. I want peace between our families. No more wars. No more bloodshed. Is that what you want too? I need to hear you say it, Roderick. Will you work with me?
I want to know the price before I agree to pay it. I'm no fool.
It seems that you are, because you clearly don't understand. Peace is the only hope your family has. My father is just waiting for an excuse to attack. Why do you think he sent my brother? So there will be trouble. My father will bring utter ruin on your house. Unless you let Griff feel like he's in control. I know you refuse to kiss my father's ring, but you would be wise to show more respect to Griff.
I'll put on a good face and let him think whatever he likes, if that's what I have to do.
It is.
My lord, a band of riders approach from the north.
Seven hells. My father's guards must be tracking me. If they catch us here, they'll kill you.
Then we've no time to waste. Let's get on with it.
My father is planning to make a move against your family. I don't know all the details, but he's been sending a great deal of gold to someone in King's Landing. I fear for your family, Roderick.
You may think you've nothing more to lose. He is ready to show you otherwise.
And what's more, he knows exactly how weak you are.
What? How?
Because you have a traitor in your council. Someone who knows every detail of your circumstances. My father boasts of it.
You must tell me. Who is it?
I don't know. We know you're planning to rescue Ryan. Even if it means abandoning your home to Griff.
What?
My father's guards are close. I need to know you'll do what I've asked. Promise me you'll submit to Griff. If you want peace between our families, it's the only way.
There's no way I can make that promise.
I could have helped you, but now I won't be coming here again. There's been enough killing. I hope you do your part.
My lord, those riders are nearly upon us. We have to go.
What I told you. Be careful what you do with it. And remember, I'll hear about it if you don't.
Lord?
Come along, Duncan.
Mother.
Roderick. Look at what's become of our house. You were nowhere to be found, and they just... Oh, they are vile men. Where were you? We need you here to hold this house together. You're troubled. What's wrong?
Lord Whitehill is plotting against us. I don't know his plans, but I fear them. And the only way he'll stop is if we submit to Griff's rule of our house.
What? Would you really give up control of our house? Griff is already a torment. How much worse could it get?
I have to keep the peace with Griff, even if that means letting him have his way at times.
The thought of it makes me ill.
I don't like it either.
Was this all? Did you learn anything more? You need to tell me.
Is it not bad enough for your ready?
It's bad enough having their soldiers in our house. But if you won't be open with me, then our problems run deeper.
Oi, bud Ethan.
Go and get in there.
You do what you're told.
No, please.
I'm just
no,
you.
No, Hold on.
Hold on, he was standing over there.
No, he was.
No, he was over there.
You know.
Get down there.
Get down there.
What do you want from me?
No, he was over there.
And Ramsay was here.
I'll play it how I want.
You will bend the knee to your liege lord.
I must speak true. I haven't the balls to defy you, lord.
What is this? What are you bastards doing?
Oh, look here. It's the new lord.
You're in luck. We're just getting to the best part. Little Lord Ethan's final breath. Unless you want to play the Lord of House Forrester instead.
You can't do this! Get out of our house! Right now!
We'll do as we please. Besides, we're not finished.
You must stop.
Oh, I know you've seen it before, but it gets better every time.
Show some respect in my house, in my home.
And that's what we're doing. Remembering young Ethan as he was.
Oh, please, no.
Say hello to your father.
Oh, no, Ethan.
He's down.
Oh, well done, well done. I'd say he died better than the real Ethan. What about you, eh? You want to be next?
Men without honor are lower than dogs.
I'd be happy to dirty my blade with your blood.
Before this is over, your blood will join my brother's on that floor. So I hope this was all worth it.
It'll be worth it when I pull this blade from your neck and see the life drain out your eyes.
Right,
make his mother
no
watch.
Fucking about
now we'll really have some fun.
Enough! Griff will deal with him. When he's done, he'll own this fucking house. And he'll have more than just words for you. Take your boy out of here while you still can.
Roderick! Roderick!
Now is not the time.
Wendell, pack the extra rations. Duff, make sure the quivers are full and the torches are dry. Garrod.
What's happening?
We're heading north of the wall to deliver justice to brothers turned traitor. They're hiding in the woods at a place called Craster's Keep. I've been looking for volunteers.
The cowards murdered Commander Mormon.
We're going to kill every one of them.
I'll volunteer to go.
I thank you for that. I need every sword I can get.
But Britt's going too.
He took his vows in the Sept. He's a brother now.
I understand why you hate him. But bad blood could jeopardize this mission. Too many unknowns out there. I can't have my own men killing each other.
I'm a ranger now. I've left my past behind me, Britt included.
Until you're standing next to him with a sword in your hand. That's the real test. If you do come, I need to know there won't be any trouble. Even if he provokes you.
Can I count on you? I need your word, Garrod. I'll be taking a chance.
I'm a man of my word. I won't disappoint you.
I'll hold you to that.
It's a hard road to Craster's. We leave tomorrow at first light.
Now why don't you go talk to those two? They volunteered as well, make sure they're ready. Doff! Where are my arrows?
Well, what did Jon Snow say? I don't think he likes us much. Definitely doesn't like you, Finn. Haven't heard him singing your praises any.
He wants to see us work together. No more problems.
That's on you.
Point is, he doesn't want any problems with either of you on this Craster's mission.
Well, it's something you should know, then. I borrowed this from you.
What?
I just got curious. I wanted to know why your uncle was here.
It never ends with you.
Oh, didn't mean no harm, honest. I just wanted a quick look. I wasn't stealing. Always planned on giving it back.
You can't keep doing that, Cotter. Next time, ask.
Well, I did try. And you just said your uncle was here about Ironwood. But I think it was something else. I noticed this part here.
Northgrove. That's just some shit story for little kids. A rumor.
No, it's not.
Of course it is. I heard it's a witch's den where they turn children into giants. Garrett, you don't actually take it seriously, do you? It's a fairy tale. For idiots. Everyone knows that. Didn't think you were that gullible.
Oh, it's real, Finn. Aye. Says it's somewhere on the other side of the wall.
And here I thought you might have some brains, Garrett. You two deserve each other. Have fun chasing your tails.
Good. Didn't need him anyway.
What do you mean?
Finn doesn't know about the mammoths. Or White Walkers. Or how to sneak past a giant.
What, and you do?
You know, it's the things you hear about. The rumours is all. I wouldn't know myself. How could I?
Rumours my arse. You're hiding something, Cotter.
I'm not. They're just things I hear around Castle Blacksall. People talk, you know.
Not about the North Grove, they don't.
And you do? Probably heard you talking about it. Or maybe one of the recruits.
Don't make me regret lying about the knife for you, Cotter. Tell me what you know.
All right. I've been on the other side of the wall, Garrett. You see, I live there, in the north. I'm part of the free folk. People round here call wildlings. I know it's crazy. I was with some other free folk. We were looking for weapons, south of the wall. We got caught, so I passed myself off as a local and, well, they sentenced me here to Castle Black for stealing. I shouldn't be here. This isn't my place. I didn't know what else to do.
Are you putting me on, Cotter?
I wouldn't joke about that. They'd kill me if they found out. Are we... We still friends? I mean... I know it's a lot to take in. And I'd understand if you were angry.
Don't worry. Bloodthirsty wildling or not, we're still brothers.
That is good to hear. At least when Mance Raider wants to boil you alive, you'll know someone in high places.
Cotter! What did I say? That shithouse you fixed is still leaking!
I'll be right there. I'm going back home, no matter what, Garrett. I've heard stories. Old tales of a secret forest within a forest. Your lord knew what he was talking about.
You know where the North Grove is?
No. But I'll help you find it. I'm deserting anyway, heading back home. If I can guide you, keep you alive. Stick with me and I'll show you the way. Plenty of things out there want to kill you. Others want to eat you.
I don't understand. Why would you want to help me? The North Grove has nothing to do with you.
I've got my own reasons for going.
Cutter! Now!
On the way!
Please, don't tell anyone about me. The Watch would kill me if they found out.
Marine still smells like shit, even outside the walls.
We'll find Croft here, somewhere. You alright?
Never better. Back under the Mad King, they used to say death by sword was a sweet kiss. But fire would fuck you hard.
Funny.
No. No, not very.
I'll go find Croft's tent.
Asher, I need you to tell me the truth. I've come a long way to bring you home. Back in that cave, you made a choice. You must have thought only one of us was going to survive. Now, it's not a fair question to ask, but I need to know.
I fought beside you, Uncle, too many times to count. I figured you could handle yourself. Beskar was the one face to face with a dragon.
I appreciate the respect, but it's not about that. Look, I can't blame you if your feelings about me are conflicted. Or your feelings about going home. Your family exiled you to this place. But I swore an oath to your mother. Sailed halfway around the world to bring you back safe. And I'd be damned if some dragonfire or your foul decisions are gonna stop me. Are we clear? I'm here to help you, to protect you. We're defined by the choices we make, Asher. One day, you'll understand that.
Asher, I know where Croft is.
This Croft, how well do you know him?
Too well.
I thought you said you were friends.
Yeah, we are. We are. Great friends.
Asher fucking Forrester. Son of a poxy whore. You have some balls walking into my tent after all these years with that mama's monkey grin on your face.
Well, that went well. Great friends indeed.
All right, maybe I deserve that.
That's not even a taste of what you deserve. You never understood consequences, Asher. One stupid mistake cost me an eye. But you'd never learn. You figured you'd steal from me and I'd just forgive you? Not a fucking chance! So how are you going to pay me back? Your eye? Your hand? Or how about your tongue?
Croft, no!
Be reasonable!
I am reasonable! I'm letting him fucking choose!
My hair could use a trim. Take some off the top, would you?
Do not fucking test me!
Croft, I deserve your anger as much as Asher.
Don't worry, Beskar. You're next. Now choose, or I slice off your balls, Asher.
A man
betrays my trust. There's a price
Stop
to be
this.
Paid.
Let him go!
Enough!
No more fucking about! Have it your way. You didn't need your testicles anyway.
Oh, that was bloody beautiful. Fucking Asher. You were pale as a snow bear's ass.
Are you fucking joking?
You bloody bastard.
This is why people steal your shit and take off in the night.
Come on, you assholes. Have a drink.
Jodan, the Khaleesi's best wine.
Your friend has an interesting sense of humor.
So what in seven hells are you two doing here on the arse end of the earth, eh?
You're a long way from, young guy.
We have a proposition for you.
We? You're hardly the usual rabble these two travel with.
Your sword was always the quickest, Croft. I need you and your men to fight for me in Westeros.
We need your hellhounds. 100 good men.
And why in a hobby's tit would I ever go back to Westeros?
I've got it good right here. Her Grace pays good coin. I've got wine, women, I've got my own tent!
If you don't join me, my family will die. I'm here because I need you, Crawford.
Oh, shit. I don't even know your fucking family and you're breaking my heart. I swear by the warrior, I'd help you if I could, but it's not up to me.
The Second Sons are sworn to Daenerys Targaryen. I've laid my sword at her feet.
For now.
Perhaps we could talk to her.
She's a little busy right now, commanding a fucking siege. Her enemies are nailing children up on post for 100 miles, and a bloody dragon's gone missing.
But I know where to find her dragon.
Ha! Unfucking likely. You expect me to believe you just happened to have seen the one fucking dragon loose in the world? Impossible.
Black scales all over with a red frill running down his back.
That doesn't prove anything. Enough of this nonsense. We're done here, Asher. You two back in my life.
I've got proof, you old fuck. Tell me what this is, if not a bloody dragon tooth.
I wouldn't know a dragon tooth from a basilisk dick.
Croft, I've seen her dragon.
Oh, bugger me with a bloody spear. If you're lying about this, it'll cost more than your balls.
Fair enough.
Come on, you son of a bitch. The beast's name is Drogon. She'll want to hear about him right away. And don't think you're going to charm her with that fucking Asher grin.
Day tomorrow, isn't it? Off to Craster's Keep. Assuming you're not too busy looking for your North Grove.
I thought you didn't believe in it.
Not saying I do. But if it was real, can you trust Cotter with it? You ask me. There's just something off about him. Aside from him being an oily thief, I mean. Like he's holding something back.
Cotter's not a bad sort. I trust him.
Even after he tried stealing your map. Do as you like. But if we're going out there tomorrow, in the middle of fucking nowhere, I'd want to know who I can trust.
Finn, get back on watch until your relief arrives.
They're late.
You think Mance Rayder is going to wait for them?
Right. Asshole.
And Tuttle, you've got torches that have gone out. Keep them lit. Let the wildlings know we're still home.
Yeah, this one's still good. Ironwood for sure. Uncle Duncan brought these from Ironrath. Wonder if I'll ever see it again. If anyone tries coming over the wall, well, those will stop them. Solid ice. This won't be melting anytime soon. be here soon. Wonder who's riding it.
Pig farmer. A 300-mile war, and you're still in my way.
I figured we'd settle things on the way to Crastus, but this is even better. Jon Snow can't hold your hand now.
I don't have any time for you anymore, Bryn. I hate you. You hate me. Now let's move on.
Had something more painful in mind. I did duty to my lord back on that bloody farm. If for doing a proper job of it, what I get? Banished to the fucking wall! I never did tell you about your father, did I?
We bled him at first, like a pig. Seemed only fair he should feel what it's like. Near the end, he could barely breathe. Kept begging us to leave your sister alone, so I made sure he was still alive when she started screaming. It was the last thing your father ever heard. The more we sliced, the worse it got.
Shrieking the whole time.
You're not worth it.
I didn't come here to chat, you fucking cunt. Too bad your father didn't fight like that. I'd still be alive. And I thought you were going to make this easy.
Stop, damn it! I don't want to fight you!
What's the matter? Don't you want to make your father proud? Let's see if you scream like you're... You got lucky, pig farmer. You're going to slaughter me, like my man back at your farm. At least let me have my sword. Keep it interesting. Or are you afraid?
I swore my vows. I won't kill a brother.
You're fucking pathetic, Tuttle. Finish it! Go on!
We're done here.
Finn!
These people are all scared, my lord. The White Hills have driven them away from the Ironwood Forests.
Out of the way!
And now they come here, starving, looking for food, food we don't have to spare. How can we support an army and reclaim our place in the north if we can't even feed a handful of peasants? Our backs are at the wall again, and this won't get better on its own.
No one has more fight in them than Asher. I'm sure he and Malcolm will find us the army we need.
We'd better hope we figure something out. With those White Hill bastards in our house, we must be wary.
Come on, you!
Let me go! You can't do this!
Good. You're here. Look. Look at this! Did you see what this girl did? She attacked my man like an animal.
Bloody bit me.
Yeah, now it's her turn. She's gonna get what she has coming to her. This won't go unpunished.
Let go of me.
I don't care if it's your sister.
He deserved it.
You'll do no such thing. I won't allow it.
That's not for you to decide.
I saw him stealing from our kitchen. And I told him to stop. He laid his hands on me. So I bit him.
Bloody wench!
I was only doing what had to be done.
I warned you not to mistreat my men. Someone will have to answer for this. Do you hear me? Don't make this ugly.
Thieves have to be punished, so your man got what he deserved. He's lucky he didn't get any worse than that.
So you've given over your duty to this girl, then? Or can you not control your sister?
Don't listen to him, Roderick.
And if you can't rein her in, yeah, what about the rest of them? It's about time she saw a real lord again and learned proper discipline. They've all been missing that.
You're afraid of a young girl with all the armed soldiers you
have. What? I'm not afraid! I want order! But this house is in a shambles. And the problem starts at the top, Roderick.
Watch your tongue, boy.
You yourself had the gall to make threats against my men. And that's the real problem with you foresters. You're too fucking proud. Always have been. It was bad enough when you were above us. And now it's even worse. Because you don't see how far you've fallen.
Still high enough to look down at you.
Now here's a brave and wise girl. A girl who knows how to speak the truth of things.
No. A girl who should know her... That's how I like to see you, Foresters. Oh, foolish Roderick. Now I'll have to put you in your place. You will learn some fucking humility. Oh, this won't be the last lesson I teach you, Foresters!
Have you no honour? I'll run you through for that. I'll cut you down like straw men.
Stand down, Roiland.
As you wish.
I bet this makes you angry, eh? You probably want to get up and hit me. But we know how that would go, don't we? Now, are you going to be a good little forester, learn your lesson, and stay down?
Roderick!
I will not yield.
You bloody snot! Why don't you fucking get it?
Get up, Roderick!
Stay down, my lord.
Your brother Ethan didn't know his place either. Ramsay Snow taught him good. Talia here will meet the same end. Unless you're a good little forester, you learn your place and stay down.
Some forester is gonna learn their lesson today.
You don't have to do that, Lord Griff.
Don't you dare! You stay down! Stay in the mud like a dog!
This is my place! You fool!
My lord!
What?! Bloody cripple! Are you fucking deaf?!
You! You'll never keep the foresters down!
Hold there! Or you're next!
Please, Lord Quiff, not the arm! If you persist, Lord Roger may lose it!
Now, stay down!
Tell me!
Will you be a good little forester?
You can't. I command you!
Let him alone!
I'll do as I like! You should fear me! I'm in charge here!
Have you had enough, Griff? Are we done here?
Don't think this is over, Roderick! You'll see! I will make you suffer for this! Trust in that!
My boy.
Careful, he's badly injured.
Roderick, you didn't let him do it. He couldn't keep you down.
You were brave. But there will be consequences, my son. We both know that.
Do you see that? Standing up to Griff has made him harsh. More severe.
Form up!
He could have killed you. But what you did, the strength you showed us, looked like yourself again. It was good to see.
We'll all fight back in time. We'll take back our house.
I know we will. And when you're better, things will be different. I asked Ethan not to change who he was. I tried to make him promise me. I now know that was childish of me. I'm ready to change now. I'm willing to do anything to help our family. I mean it, Roderick. I don't care what. I'll do it.
I am too.
Father used to say we foresters are as tough as the ironwood.
We are.
All of us. And I'm sure the others will do whatever it takes as well. What you did, provoking Griff, it hasn't taken our house to war just yet. But...
no one can know the future. Whatever tomorrow brings, Talia, foresters will stand tall.
I did it. I can't believe it. What are you waiting for?
I can't.
What? After everything, we just...
I can't burn it.
The Khaleesi will see you now.
So, Asher Forrester, if you presume to speak of my dragons, choose your words carefully.
What have you done, Garrett? Frostfinger is calling for your head. Tell me Britt's death was an accident.
Mira, what are you doing? I can't pretend I haven't seen this. Mira, just tell me what's going on.
We are weak.
We have no allies.
And Griff will make us pay for your defiance.
There's been a raven from Lord Whitehill. He's invited us to High Point.
Drogon wouldn't have attacked without reason.
By order of the Queen!
Fuck you and your Queen!
Deal with your friend.
Nothing ever stays in the past, Asher.